Hello. Welcome to Productions MJC. Well, Multi Tom Tom is at it again with a new release telling us the Flat Earth is bigger than we've been told. Well, at least it's not more of that optical illusion crap they're so fixated on, so hey, let's get on with it.
What if I were to tell you that the Earth is much bigger than the circumference of 24,901 miles? And that nothing about this map is correct. Not the land masses, not the orientation, not the distances.
As to the size, we'll see, but about the others, I would tend to agree simply because any projection of a round object onto a flat surface will have distortions, irregularities, incorrectness. So what?
So it is my duty to debunk the heliocentric model, globe, and this map.
Whoa, hold on there, camper. You went from this map has distortions to the whole world is messed up and wrong. That's a little, you know, A to Z with nothing in between. You got to do better than that. I expected you would go a little bonkers, but man, that was right off the bat.
But first, let me give you a history lesson. At the time of Chris Columbus...
Hold on. Your map is 1,100 years before the time of Christopher Columbus. Where are you going with this?
This was the known world. Europe, Northern Africa, India, and parts of the Far East, China.
Okay, then he goes on and on talking about the history of the world, talking about all sorts of other stuff. What's funny is... at the very first of it, he shows us a Robinson projection of the Earth, which is a modified Mercator. He's showing us all these different versions of the maps and saying, but people really don't know. This is his assertion. People really didn't know what was inside of the outside shape. So they had to figure out with their imagination how far it was, how it was shaped, and everything else. Well, of course... then he looks at a modern Mercator or Robinson projection or other projection and then says, these people had to imagine this. This is just imagination because it really isn't known. It's one of those flat earth things where they assert they have disproved the globe because we couldn't possibly know it was a globe. To them, everything is about doubt of a globe. And so the flat earth is, in their mind, perfect in every way, and the globe is just simply imagination. And what he tries to reinforce in his so-called air quote history lesson is we don't know. The cartographers didn't really know what the land looked like. They didn't know anything about it. So it was all just imagination and guesswork when they created a map. So maps are simply just imaginations and just things that simply appeared in people's minds. They don't exist in reality. To them, that's their whole contention. That's what he was trying to reinforce.
And funnily enough, timeanddate.com used the Mercator map on their website today.
For convenience sake, because all of the lines are straight up and down?
Timeanddate.com are the gatekeepers of the heliocentric model.
Wow, that's a big responsibility. What before 1998? And who, supposedly before 1998, were the gatekeepers?
They use it as their time zone map.
Again, probably because of the simplicity of the layout. Vertical, up and down.
And there is so much wrong with this map.
Well, of course there is. It's a flat projection of a round object.
Which I will explain a bit later.
Oh, sweet mother, just rip the bandage off now and do it. Come on.
They are also hiding huge amounts of land, especially the north and south from 60 degrees to 90 degrees.
Oh, sweet heaven above. He thinks Greenland is really that big. I've got to be wasting my time with sarcasm. Nobody's that stupid. He doesn't really think that, does he?
Thousands of miles of ice and land are being hidden.
Like I tell everybody that I debate in chats and posts and other stuff, I have heard an assertion from you. Where's your evidence? Where's your reasoning? It's called ARE, and they teach it in high school debate. Come on!
Similarly, they do not show the land to sea ratio. They tell us that the oceans cover 70% of the earth and land 30%. So what they have done is when they produce maps, they simply flip it around by showing us 70% land and 30% ocean.
Well, actually to me it looks like 50-50, but you gotta keep in mind the distortions because of the top and bottom of the map. But what am I doing? This is a sarcasm channel. We are being punked.
People don't comprehend how big the Pacific Ocean is.
Well, of course they don't. I mean, they don't even comprehend how big Lake Ontario is, let alone the Pacific Ocean.
You must understand the following information about this map.
He then drones on about how the Earth is divided into 24 time zones, and I don't want to confuse somebody who might be on the edge of flat Earth belief instead of understanding how a globe works. But time zones aren't really straight up and down exact. There are even parts of countries that have decided to make their local time different from solar time.
They have compressed the continent of Asia into such a tiny area of land.
Again, this is a projection. If you want to see it better, use a globe.
They made it so small.
What's actually small is your mind's ability to grasp anything. I mean, seriously. We're being punked. We're being punked. We're being punked. I mean, he then goes on and on about China and how the time of different cities, Chongqing, Beijing, or wherever, are the same. Well, duh. That's because the government says they're the same. Even if they're in different actual physical areas where the sun, the solar time, will be different, they don't care. They want the whole country on the same time. So that's the way it is. But we're being punked. We're being punked. Nobody is this stupid.
Another anomaly is here. Urumqi and Howid, Mongolia. It should be the other way around because Howid is more easterly than Urumqi, and the time is the other way around. They flipped it.
I don't normally do this, but if this person is serious, they really need to be institutionalized immediately. Somebody needs to find him and do it. If this isn't a sarcasm channel or, you know, a joke channel, if this person really feels and thinks this stuff, they are dangerous.
And another example, Moscow in Russia and Anadyr, Russia, on the far eastern coast. They tell us the distance is 3,848 miles with a flight time of 7.5 to 8 hours. But the problem is that they're 10 time zones away, 10 hours difference. So they should be at least 9,000 miles apart, not 3,848 as given.
Oh, okay, there we go. There's the flat earth deception. Gotcha. Right. Okay, let me explain this. They're actually 9 time zones apart, so let's work with that. But first, let's get another assertion in.
What they're also doing is
messing
with the distance and the flight times.
Actually, the thing that's messing with the flight times and the distances is your inability to see 3D objects with your mind when you're looking at a 2D object. You can't even comprehend the 3D object, let alone switching back and forth between the two. But you're smart. You're pulling a good trick that nobody probably realized. Oh, there are a few out there, but some people right on the edge won't realize it. So let's help them out. You're doing two things to twist people's minds. So let's work on that mind twist. And number one, the figure you're quoting of X amount of miles per time zone is for the equator, not the Arctic Circle. congratulations on that mind bender, but you had to figure somebody would understand it and catch it. I mean, come on. Near the Arctic Circle, I mean, way above it, the actual physical distance between time zones, as they're called, could be as little as 500 yards. And if you were standing within a few hundred yards of the North Pole, you could literally throw a baseball across four time zones.
So what these messers doing is they're using, when they calculate time and distance, what they're doing is they're using the airspeed and not the ground speed.
Airspeed, ground speed? Well, stay tuned.
The airspeed is almost half of that ground speed. So in reality, the distance from Moscow to Anadyr is anything between 7 to 10,000 miles, like I said, not 3,848 as given by them.
Oh yeah, that's right. I forgot that part about the mind bend. I did say two things. Yes. And let me get into them a little bit more. But the other thing is that flight time, he went on before quoting jet engines and commercial flights and all this. Well, what I could find is that's actually a prop, a propeller-driven airplane that's only going to do 120 knots, not 400 to 500 knots like a big old jet, baby. I love how he supposedly hates the Dayton time map and yet uses it to try to prove his point by manipulating it. There's that airspeed, ground speed crap. A Fiat 500 is not a Ferrari F50, so it's going to take a little longer to get there. Yeah. Now, that's the kind of flat earth trickery I was looking for. Look at my left hand, don't look at my right hand. Let me talk about a commercial jet doing 400 to 500 knots when you're actually pitter-puttering along in a prop job doing 120 knots. See, that's the flat earth trickery, chicanery, sleight of hand, swapping junk, and yep, that's the kind of smokescreen crap job I expected, and thank you for producing. Now, next. I've grown tired of his droning on about crap. He then goes into the conspiracy theory about the air transportation around the world being members of United Nations, and I'm no fan of United Nations. I think it's stupid for the United States to have them in there. I digress. Never mind. Anyway, this, he goes on about civil air patrols, civil aeronautics administration, FAA, all this blah blah blah, and how they're all tied together and they're all in it together to try to make the world seem smaller than it really is. Anybody can take a globe and stretch a string from Moscow to what Anadyr, and then they can actually measure it against the scale on the globe. That's probably the best way to do it, and then ding ding ding, be about 4,000 miles. But he wants you to think that somehow there's a conspiracy to make the world smaller than it really is.
So, in conclusion, a far larger Earth debunks the globe, debunks the heliocentric model, debunks the circumference of the Earth, therefore the radius. Nothing about the globe works.
Nothing about your fake globe works. I agree. You presented a magic trick, sleight of hand, fake globe, and it doesn't work.
The heliocentric model had its run for just over 500 years, and it's time for it to stop.
Actually, what needs to stop is the magic tricks, optical illusions, fake figures and fake calculations. Do it the right way and it works.
It's time for the authorities and all the educational establishments everywhere, all over the globe, pardon the pun, to teach the truth from now on.
It's actually time for you to stop trying to teach that magic tricks are real. It's time for you to follow other flat earth video makers' advice and stay away from evidence and reality and talk about feelings, because you lose to reality every time. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed that. Please like and subscribe. Have a good day. This has been Productions MJC.